grayscale image that I'm going to translate into a depth map, and I just wanted to sort of walk through sort of how this works. So black is the bottom of the depth map, the lowest point of the depth map. White is the highest point on the depth map, so these would be at the highest point. And the levels of gray from black to white indicate sort of an increase. So this edge right here goes from black to 90% gray, so that's a 10% of the height. And then here, this is 80% gray, this is 70% gray, this is 60% gray, 50% gray, 40% gray. And so that steps up 10% of the height that you set at the end. So the same thing is happening here. And I'm using blend just to blend from one platform, one square to another, and I get a nice smooth gradient when I do that. I've got some other sort of, I'm playing around with gradients inside some of these. You can see the fill for this goes from a, it's probably like a 40% gray to white, or sorry, white on the outside of 40% gray. So I expect this to have a little cup in it. This is like a platform that then has two more raised elements. This will probably be a cone. This will be a stepped platform that's also twisting. So the important thing is to start at 90 to 95% gray here for the platform, just to give yourself a good foundation to work on. I've also added some 85% gray lines here just to add a little linear texture, but you don't want it to be too deep, otherwise it'll get stuck when you try and do a vacuum form out of it. So now that we've got this, what we're going to do is we're going to export it as a PNG. So I'm going to File, Export, Export As. Then I'm going to set it as a PNG. I'm going to export. And then I'm going to set the resolution to other 900 pixels per inch. I'm going to turn anti-aliasing off, so there's no anti-aliasing. Anti-aliasing creates sort of artifacts, so you start to get weird sort of edges. So it's better to just leave this off and click OK. So that's exporting out. If you set that number higher than 900 to like 1200 or 1500, it's gonna get overly large and detailed. So now that we've got that, we'll move on to the next step, which will be to process it in Photoshop.